Hello and welcome to the Divi Child Theme Beginner Guide. Today I wanted to talk to you about what WordPress child themes are, the types of Divi child themes you may see, and how to create a blank Divi child theme. So if you want a simple explanation to help you quickly decide whether you need to use a child theme, and if yes, what kind, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Ania and my goal here is to help you build beautiful websites. And usually you'd see me giving you a walkthrough on how to achieve a certain thing in Divi. Many times you would see me writing custom CSS and placing it inside my child theme style sheet. So this time I would like to take a step back because I think that there are so many casual Divi users who just need a quick explanation and maybe an advice if they really do need a child theme when working with Divi. So this video is for them. Okay, let's get started. First, as a Divi user, you might often hear about Divi child themes, but this is actually a WordPress concept. A child theme can be created for any WordPress theme, but yes, I am going to focus on Divi. So years ago, WordPress themes didn't have that many customization options available in our dashboard. We had a theme customizer with some basic options, but if you wanted to make changes to your site, oftentimes you would need to use custom code and edit the theme files. But as you probably know, any WordPress theme needs to be updated from time to time to keep it functional and secure. Updating a theme means replacing all the theme files with the new updated versions. And normally this will not break or delete anything, but if you've inserted your own PHP, CSS, or JavaScript code directly into the theme files, if you did that and then updated the theme, all the files with your edits would be deleted and replaced with the new files. To prevent this, you can use a child theme. So while keeping the parent theme files intact, you can insert your custom code into the child theme files, and this will prevent it from being overwritten when the parent theme gets updated. And I will explain exactly how it works in just a moment, but first, you might be already thinking, I do not want to touch any custom code, but yet I see comments that I always need to use a child theme. So do you need to have one or not? I don't think you always need to use a child theme, because with Divi being such a robust page builder and with the power of the Divi theme builder, there aren't really that many occasions where you would have the need to edit any of the theme files. So if you aren't planning to edit the original theme files in any way, it's likely you do not need a child theme at all. Even if you're adding some custom CSS in Divi, you will not need a child theme if you are using the designated custom code spaces, like inside Divi theme options, in the code module, or in the advanced tab of any builder element. These CSS modifications will not be affected by a Divi theme update. But yes, there's a but. I think that applies only if you use CSS sparingly and can easily keep track of where your code is, where it's located, and easily find and edit it. If you write a lot of custom code for your websites, like we do, a blank child theme is a convenient way to keep all your CSS in one place and, you know, edit, work on it directly from a code editor through FTP, for example. You may find that, you know, little box inside the theme options not very convenient when you have over 100 lines of CSS. So again, if you need to edit the original theme files in any way or write a lot of custom code, you will need a blank child theme. And the reason I say blank child theme is because with Divi we also have premium child themes. So just like the blank child theme, a premium one is also a theme dependent on the Divi theme, but it is not blank. A premium child theme is a fully functional theme with premium design and styling. It is actually a fully designed website customizable using the Divi functionality. As an example, I am a child theme creator myself, so Divi Lover premium child themes contain a variety of different pages. The homepage, of course, about me page, blog archives, single blog posts, a sale page, all designed in a consistent matching way. They also include a variety of pre-styled modules, which you can pick and choose to customize and structure your own layouts. And all modules are kept in the same consistent style, which means you can add a module from the library and all the styling will already be implemented. The main advantage to using a premium child theme is the time you'll be saving, because most of the child themes offered for Divi will have some sort of easy one-click installation process that will create a copy of the child theme demo page on your website, and all is left to do is to edit the text and images. So who might need a premium child theme? It kind of depends. Casual WordPress users who just want to set up a website for themselves might find this a bit pricey, because if you want to use a Divi child theme, you must purchase the Divi theme as well. But if you do have Divi elegant theme subscriptions, all you have to pay is the child theme, and it's usually a huge time saver and a guarantee of a nice looking design. So if you're planning to build a website for yourself and you want that head start and you found a child theme that looks similar to what you're trying to accomplish, you will be able to customize your website using the Divi theme capabilities. So purchasing a premium child theme is worth considering. And another group of premium Divi child theme users are professional web designers who use them to simply save time on projects for their clients. Using a child theme as a basis for designing a website, well, it makes the process much faster and easier, as long as the end result is similar to what you're trying to achieve. So I have to mention a free alternative to premium child themes. Another way to kickstart a website if you have Divi is using a layout pack. So Elegant Themes offers hundreds of different layouts for free, which every subscriber can download directly into the Divi Builder. If you only need a simple, functional website with a few pages, this is a great option. Layouts are not child themes though. If you're using a layout pack, you need to import each page separately and also customize it separately. Premium child themes will have a lot of global customization options, as well as more advanced features such as pop-ups, pre-styled plugins, things like that. So I hope you found this explanation helpful. Now, please feel free to download our sample child theme from the Divi Lover website, which you can use as is or as a starting point. Because if you prefer a more hands-on approach, let me show you how exactly child themes work and how you can create and edit a blank child theme yourself, because creating a child theme manually is much easier than it sounds. And let me show you. Now, I have a folder on my computer disk, and inside you can see my style CSS file and functions PHP file and also an image. A child theme only needs these two files to work, a style CSS and a functions PHP file. And you can use a simple text editor to create and edit these files, as long as you can save each with the correct file extension. But I think using a code editor is much more convenient. So the style CSS file must contain information about the parent theme to establish the connection between the two themes. This is also where you can add your theme name, description, author name, URL, all the information that will be visible in the WordPress appearance panel. Just do not change that template name. It needs to be Divi to work correctly. And functions.php file, the most important code here is the enqueue function, which will load the child themes CSS file. And here is where you would put any additional PHP code your site might need. And another file that you would very likely need is that screenshot. The name of the file needs to stay the same, screenshot, and you can use PNG or JPEG, and it will display a child theme thumbnail in the WordPress dashboard. This could be your logo or your client's logo, for example. So that is the most basic version of the child theme. Now you could upload this folder through FTP directly inside WP content / themes on your server, or you can zip it. And on Mac, I just need to right click and compress. I'm sure it's similar on Windows. So now we can install this zip file as a new theme in WordPress. So in my sample website under appearance, themes, add new, upload theme, and then choose file, and we're choosing that newly created zip file, and click install now. Next, activate. When we activate it, it works right away, and all the details from the style CSS file are visible here in the dashboard. And you can edit your child theme files directly from appearance theme file editor. But I do like to open these files directly inside my code editor. So one last thing I would like to explain is making changes overwriting parent theme files, because you can use your child theme to make changes in parent theme template files such as header or footer PHP. You would need to copy the original file from the Divi theme folder and add it inside your child theme folder. It cannot be done from the dashboard. You would need to create this copy before the installation, before you create your zip file, or afterward by uploading the new file through FTP. I'm working with local WordPress installation, so I can simply navigate to my WordPress files right here in under WP content, themes, Divi. Let's say I would want to change something in the footer PHP. I can copy that file, paste that in my child theme folder. And now if I refresh that, I have my footer PHP inside my child theme. So I can, you know, edit, make some changes here. And now WordPress, if it finds any of the theme template parts, such as footer PHP, inside your child theme folder, it will use this version instead of the original file from the Divi parent theme. So if you make a change here and then update the Divi, your change is safe and the file will not be replaced with the new version. WordPress will use your footer PHP instead of Divi, and it would work the same with other theme files, except for the style CSS and functions PHP, because WordPress will process both style CSS from the child theme and style CSS from Divi, as well as functions PHP from the child theme and from the parent Divi theme. But as I mentioned earlier, with the power of the theme builder, it's not very likely you would need to do that, changing the footer or header PHP template file like this. I just think it might be useful just to understand how it works. And that would be all for now. I hope this overview of WordPress child themes, Divi child themes, was helpful. Thank you very much for watching. As always, let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and I'll see you next time.